Acts 16, verse 25 says this. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. We're going to talk about praise is what I do. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you that praise is what we do. Everything in this worship came up to this moment, Lord, to hear your voice. So, Lord, move self out of the way, Lord, and you come shining through as a ray of light, Father. May all flesh keep silence, Lord, while your spirit reigns supreme. So touch every heart here, every mind here, so that we will all hear your word, Father. Yeah. So we thank you for this moment. We don't take it for granted that we're here. We're here because of your grace and your mercy. So we thank you, Lord, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Praise is what I do. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God. Praise is what I do. In Acts, the 16th chapter, we find Paul and Silas doing what they were called to do. And what they were called to do was preach and proclaim the word of God. They prayed, and they praised, and they sang, and they were just going through the region and across the countryside doing what they were called to do. Praying and ministering and preaching the gospel to people, saints and sinners, everybody that wanted to hear the word. Paul and Silas were preaching the word. And all was well until Paul and Silas was faced with this one person that needed healing. It was this little slave girl with the spirit of divination. She was possessed by the devil with the spirit of divination. If we look back at verse 16 in the 16th chapter, we would see that Paul and Silas, they were doing their job. And this person with the spirit of divination was with them. And this little slave girl that was with them, it said she's followed them many days. She was just with them, and as she had the spirit of divination, she was just following them because she made money for her masters, and they saw another opportunity to make money, because then they started following Paul and Silas. Now, they were following Paul and Silas, first of all, because they had a crowd, and if they had a crowd, she would have a crowd with them. So she was just proclaiming what they were proclaiming, but she was of another slant. She was, again, possessed with the demon. So what she did, how she made money for her masters, is she was a fortune teller. That's how she made money for her masters. Everybody knew where her masters were. They knew who she was. But yet, she was following Paul and Silas. This girl's ability to penetrate mysteries was due, again, to a demon that was controlling her. So as that demon was controlling her, she was just using it in order to make her master's money. So Paul, in time, after he heard this slave girl enough, he just looked and he decided to call on the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and to free this girl of this demon, which he did. But as he freed her of the demon, her slave owners that was making money off of her got mad, because now they can't make no more money. Now they can't have anybody lift them up. Now they had lost their source of income. So Paul and Silas knew that if this girl had a spirit of divination, the spirit of divination is a sin, and they had to rid this girl of this sin, which they did. Because the spirit of divination carries with it some familiar things that we've heard about. Fortune telling is one, astrology, witchcraft, tarot cards, spell casting, Ouija boards. Spirit of divination, that's sin. The Bible calls it sin. But this is what this young girl, this slave girl, was doing. So anything like this or like that is a sin. So Paul and Silas recognized the demon in the slave girl and the sin, and it caused, and the sin that it caused her to live in, and they cast it out. Hooray for Paul and Silas, and God bless this little slave girl who had this demon. She walked with them many days until Paul got tired, and Paul cast that demon out. So the slave girl's masters, they were upset.
they were upset because they saw that the slave girl was broken. Meaning that she was broken, meaning they couldn't use her no more. See, when somebody can't use you no more, you got broke. Amen? And since they can't use you no more, they're going to find somebody else they can use because now you're broke. Amen? So they're going to find somebody else that they can use. So Paul and Silas, you know, after they healed her from three things. And they, all three things happened simultaneously. Because when they healed her and fixed her into the slave master, she was broken. They healed her, first of all, spiritually. Because the demon that had taken residence in her is now gone. So the first thing they healed her was spiritually. Because now that demon that was in her, causing her to sin, is there no more. So if the demon can't use her, her slave masters can't use her. So therefore, when Paul and Silas healed her, they healed her spiritually. And again, all these came at the same time. And Paul and Silas were able to, they were able to do this because praise is what they do. Amen? Because when I'm praising the Lord, I can override this other stuff. Because my job is, and my obligation is to praise God. I need to praise God from whom say all blessings flow. If all blessings flow, I'm praising God. No matter what, in season, out of season, good, bad, or indifferent, I'm praising God. God didn't tell me to praise him when I feel like it. No, I praise God anytime. Because anytime is the right time to praise my Lord. So Paul and Silas, they were able to free this girl because they stayed in constant praise with the Lord. Secondly, they freed this slave girl, and they freed all of this because they freed her socially. They freed her socially because the only friends she had were her masters. And if we look at it, her masters weren't really her friends. They were just using her. And she was a slave, so therefore, you know, they had ownership of her to use her. So they were just using her like a spiritual hooker. They were using her. However you want to call it, they were using her. So therefore, when she got freed from the demon, she got freed socially. Which means her masters didn't want her no more because there wasn't nothing in it for her. So as she got freed, she was free to go and do something else. She was free to find some new friends. She was free to find somebody that was going to really care about her. Instead of somebody that was there using her. And the third thing that she got freed from was bondage. Because she was totally hemmed up. First of all, she was in bondage by the devil because it was a demon in her. Secondly, she was in bondage by her masters because they were using her. Now that's a double dip. And she was in bondage. And Paul and Silas freed her. They freed her from that bondage. So therefore, she was in bondage no more. She was free to she was free of men. Now she was free to serve a God that loved her. So as Paul and Silas was doing this, freeing this slave girl came a reward for them. Freeing the slave girl, Paul and Silas got a great reward. Oh, they got a reward. They got a reward like none other. Because when these slave owners got upset, they went and told the authorities, and the authorities went and they whipped Paul and Silas and they threw them in jail. What a reward. Oh, look, the slave girl that they freed, they weren't thinking about that no more. She's broken. She not even an issue. They don't even talk about her no more. Their thing went to Paul and Silas, we lost our money, now we're going to beat you and put you in jail. And if you've been to Israel, jail is really jail. They stuck you in a hole in the ground. Because it says that they were in the inner prison.
Yes, yes.
Which means they had no light, no air, no water, no ventilation. They were just down in a hole after they were beaten. So after they were beaten and put in that inner prison for their reward, it says that Paul and Silas, they got down there and they did one thing that they did best. Because they never stopped doing this. The scripture said they were praying and praising God. Meaning that praise is what they did. And praise is what they did even before this whole thing started. They didn't get down here and just start praising. They were praising because that's what they knew to do. I tell you, you're going to stop praising when something happened. You need to praise right now when everything's going all right. You need to just shout and give God some praise. You need to praise God when things are going bad. You just need to praise him anyway. If God do God, you just need to praise God just because. Did you wake up this morning? Did you praise God for it? I tell you, if anybody can block your praise, you got a problem. It ain't God, because God called us to praise. See, when I got up this morning, I just said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. When I walked in these doors this morning, I said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You know, my praise isn't based off of everything. It's just based off of the God I serve. So when Paul and Silas went through all of this, and after they freed this girl, and after they beat them, really for no reason at all, just delivering this little girl, they went in jail and they started praising and just singing to God. And it got so good to God at this point, because God knew what they were doing. It says that an angel started rocking the jail and shook all the chains and all the bands off the jail.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Because praise is what they did. And as they praised, they not only freed themselves, they freed everybody else. But since authorities put them in jail, they said, look, when a jailer came and said, hold up, let me kill myself. Because they were made to hold these prisoners, and if they lost one, they had to forfeit their life. But as he whipped out his sword, Paul said, hold up, brother, we ain't going nowhere. We just have an old-fashioned spiritual prayer power. We just praising the Lord. None of us ain't going nowhere because we're having such a good time praising our Lord. We're going to stay right here until daybreak. Amen? So when they start praying, you know, praise is just what they did. And I'm telling you, sometimes in our hour, we need to praise.
That's right.
I tell you, when you're down, when you're out, when you're not feeling good, that's the best time to pray.
Hallelujah.
Amen? When the doctors give you bad news, that's the best time to pray.
Amen.
I tell you, when you're short on that cash, that's the best time to pray. When you look in your cupboard and your cupboard half bare, that's the best time to pray. Amen. When you look at your bills and your bills are due and you don't have much, that's a good time to praise the Lord. Hey, when you look at your friends and you ain't got none, that's a good time to praise the Lord. Because if you got Jesus as a friend, you got it all. Amen. So praise is what you do. I tell you, praise is what you do when I want to be close to you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. It says, I lift my hands in praise.
Yeah.
I think it's a song that goes like that.
Hallelujah.
Praise is who I am. I will praise you while I can. I will bless you, Lord, at all times.
Yeah.
And I'll come to praise you.
Yeah.
Anybody come to praise the Lord?
Hallelujah.
Anybody come to praise the Lord today? I want to see if any praises in the house today. Anybody come to praise the Lord today? Stop you from praising
Thank
God.
You, Lord.
The gods that you serve, there ain't nothing wrong with God.
Thank you, Lord.
I was teaching that to the new members today. There's something wrong with you.
Thank you, Lord.
And you need to get your praise back on track.
Thank you, Lord.
And know the God that you serve.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Paul and Silas.
Amen.
That was a day. That was a day. I mean, after all these days, that day they decided to free that girl was a day. Because nobody expect to lay hands, heal somebody, and then get beat and thrown in jail. No, nobody expected that. I'm sure they didn't expect it, but that was part of the call. Because if you're doing God's work, hey, somebody might beat you and throw you in the jail.
Well, yes.
But continue to praise and keep praising. Because praise is what we need to continue to do. Amen?
Amen.
In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you. We just give you praise, Lord, for everything that you are, everything that you do. Thank you. Because praise is what we do.
When I'm broken, I'm still. I lift my hands in
while I can.
I will praise you while I can.
I'll bless you at all times.
I'll bless you at all times.
And I vow to praise you. Through the good and the bad.
Through the good and the bad.
I'll praise you. Whether happy or sad,
whether happy or sad,
I'll praise you. In all that I go through.
there's somebody today that does not know our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, as their personal Lord and Savior.